again
today, but I think there might be a couple of tears being shed. So I'm sure Mercedes will say, look, the penalty was too harsh. We didn't know the pit lane was closed. It ruined the race for us. It gave us a very different race.
Yeah, Lewis was first on the scene, of course, because he had such a lead, but they cannot complain about that penalty.
And of course,
the procedure was followed. The message was up on the board. It's unusual. It's highly unusual. And I can see how they fell into the track with Lewis like way out front like that. But and then Alfa Romeo obviously made the same mistake with Giovinazzi. But all the other teams spotted it and sorted it and ran it correctly.
And of course, Charles Leclerc's crash acted as a double whammy, really, because they had to take the penalty when the pack restarted and they were all close together. But that is for the after show with Simon Lazenby. At the moment, it's Lance Stroll. And come on, Lance, you're on the podium for a second time. You're alongside Carlos Sainz there. Sainz looking, well, like he would rather have a win, I'm sure, but should feel so satisfied, like the Racing Point driver, that they're up there and they gave such a great battle. But the big grin and the big smile will be on the face of this man, who might just shake his head a little bit, because I'm sure he can hardly believe what has happened this afternoon. The 109th winner in Formula One, the 109th different driver, it's Pierre Gasly.
It's so sad for these guys that they're not going to get the full Monza podium experience with no crowd underneath, because that is something else.
But I'm sure they will never forget this moment where they all stood together and Pierre Gasly winning for Alpha Tauri.
The French and the Italian national anthems then.
And for Pierre Gasly, a week after an emotional return to Spa, 12 months following on from the tragic death of Antoine Hubert, now has the ultimate high in Formula One to raise the winner's trophy aloft, the top step of the podium at Monza. And that looks like the team manager at AlphaTauri, Graham Watson, long-time servant of the team, who collects the Constructors Trophy. What a day for him as well. What a day as well for Ray Rowe, Tex Rowe, retiring from McLaren today. 82 years old, 55 years he's been with the team, their longest serving team member, a man who worked with Bruce McLaren, and I'm sure will be utterly delighted to see McLaren on the podium at his last race in Formula One. God bless you, Tex. Have a great life, my friend. And Lance Stroll there for Racing Point with their best result in Formula One. Could we see more of this in the future, Martin? Wouldn't it be great?
It would be great. Yeah, there's a lot of things coming up that are going to level the playing field, but yeah, we talked about the reverse race situation where that certainly add some excitement and would force the teams to develop their cars in a different way to be able to overtake better as well if we had reverse grid situations. But Mercedes don't leave crumbs on the table too often. You've got to make sure you're the first one to eat them.
Yep, for Mercedes today, the race was just a bit ghastly. For the winner, it was just pure Gasly. Well done, Pierre. The Italian Grand Prix, it's a home win for Alpha Tauri.
What an incredible race, and a worthy winner in the form of Pierre Gasly. The Italian national anthem being heard, but not for Ferrari. For AlphaTauri, and after everything that Pierre Gasly has been through in the past 12 months, he's just sitting down to take it all in, as Martin was saying. Such a shame that the Tifosi aren't spread out underneath him. Quite emotional, you should imagine. Crofty making such a good point. A year on from the tragedy that befell his good friend, Antoine Hubert. I wonder if he's in his thoughts right now, because just amazing, wasn't it? Everyone here really pleased with him. He's the first French winner since 1996, and that race in the rain, Johnny Herbert, one of only three drivers to finish that race, with David Coulthard and Olivier Panis the victor. But I'd stay there for a while if I was he, Paul Jensen.
The guy's been outstanding this year, hasn't he? And he got unlucky with the safety car at the last Grand Prix. It locked in today, but listen, under the pressure, under everything, to get the job done here.
In motorsport, out of motorsport, and to lift that trophy, in Italy especially, you know, AlphaTauri's home country, it's very, very special. The only thing that's missing is the fans here. That would have just made it, but he won't moan right now. There's so much emotion, and he's going to wake up in the morning a Grand Prix winner. So special.